Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In this lesson, we will see how different animals can be used to detect the quality of the environment, how different animals can be used as bioindicators. So as with any other living organisms, as with plants, as bioindicators as well, animals can also be used to detect the quality of the environment. Simple approach kya hai? Ki you can just count the number of species of a certain animal in certain environment. Or you can count the you can check the diversity of the species of that genus in that environment, and you can assess whether the environment is doing well or not. Now, variations in the population of animals may indicate harmful changes caused due to the pollution into the ecosystem. Changes in populations may be a result of the relationship between populations and food sources. We discussed in our previous lectures as well that the changes happening in the environment are both biotic and abiotic. Biotic means that the changes happening in the environment due to life, due to other living organisms, and abiotic means that changes happening in the environment due to certain other elements which are non-living elements, maybe climate changes and other such things. So, jitne bhi living organisms hain, aur yahan pe hum baat kar rahe hain animals ki, they respond differently towards different changes happening in the environment. हम यहाँ पे देखें तो यहाँ बात की जा रही है कि जो पॉपुलेशन है किसी भी एनिमल की वो फूड पे भी डिपेंड करती है. अगर कोई खास एनिमल है जिसकी फूड कोई खास प्लांट है, फॉर एग्जांपल, एंड दैट प्लांट इज नो मोर ग्रोइंग इन दैट एनवायरनमेंट ड्यू टू सर्टन कंटेमिनेंट, तो कंटेमिनेशन की वजह से प्लांट की ग्रोथ रुक गई, प्लांट ग्रो करना बंद हो गया. उस प्लांट पे जो एनिमल्स फीड करते थे, अब उन एनिमल्स को फूड नहीं मिल रही, द एनिमल्स विल स्टार्ट डाइंग एज वेल. सो दैट्स हाउ यू आर इनडायरेक्टली checking the quality of the environment, and food and prey and predator relationships are there as well to study. Animal indicators also help in detecting the amount of toxins present in the tissues of animals. Animals mein ye ability hai ki jaise bahut sare plants hain wo bahut sare pollutants ko uptake kar sakte hain, is tarah animals mein bhi bahut sare pollutants agar animals uptake kare, maybe through drinking or maybe through eating, indirectly obviously. So those contaminants, those toxicants can be stored in their different types of tissues. So if we can study different tissues of different animals, we can check whether it is having any deposition of any toxicant or not, and indirectly we will find out that if that particular environment is being exposed to that kind of toxicant or not. Frogs are also bioindicators influenced by changes that take place in their freshwater and terrestrial habitats. अगर हम फ्रेश वाटर स्टडी करना चाह रहे हैं, उसमें चेंजेस को स्टडी करना चाह रहे हैं, तो फ्रॉग्स आर बेस्ट बायोइंडिकेटर्स. अगेन यू कैन सी हियर दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एनवायरमेंट्स, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्लूटेंट्स, वी पिक एंड चूज डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बायोइंडिकेटर्स. जू प्लांकटॉन्स लाइक अलोना गटटा, मीसोसाइक्लोप्स, साइक्लोप्स इन जनरल एक्सेट्रा, these zooplanktons can also be used to study the quality of the environment. Again, these are planktons, but those are animal-based planktons, and they float freely in the environment. Invertebrates ko bhi use kiya ja sakta hai as bioindicators to detect the quality of the environment. Aquatic invertebrates ko bhi use kiya jata hai, aur inki badi ahmiyat hai. Why so? Because aquatic invertebrates are mostly bottom feeders. ये जो अपनी हैबिटेट है, एक्वाटिक हैबिटेट, उसके बॉटम पे जितने भी लाइफ है, जितने भी प्लांटेशन है, जितनी भी चीज़ें वहाँ पाई जाती हैं, उन पे फीड करते हैं. सो दीज आर बेस्ट इंडिकेटर्स ऑफ वाटर शेड. वाटर शेड को स्टडी करना हो तो बेस्ट इंडिकेटर्स जो है वो इन्वर्टिब्रेट्स हैं, एक्वाटिक इन्वर्टिब्रेट्स जो कि बॉटम फीडर्स हैं. वाई सो? वाटर शेड क्या होता है? वाटर शेड हर इलाका किसी न किसी वाटर शेड का हिस्सा होता है. एवरी रीजन इज पार्ट ऑफ सम वाटर शेड. Now there are two types of watershed. One is closed, second one is open. Watershed basically kya hai? Koi bhi ilaka jisme jitne bhi pani hai wo ikattha hokar kisi khas stream mein ja raha hai, to ye sara ek watershed kehlayega. So agar wo sara pani kisi khas ilake se ikattha hokar kisi ek river mein ja raha hai, kisi ek lake mein ja raha hai, kisi ek nadi nale mein ja raha hai, that is a closed watershed. Lekin koi aisa ilaka hai jisme se pani jitna beh ke directly oceans mein ja raha hai, that is called open watershed. So if we can study the bottom feeders of certain river, we can study indirectly the quality of that watershed. So that's why these invertebrates are said to be the best suited, best choice of bioindicators to study the quality of any watershed, because the feed in a water body which is collecting water from that watershed.